Hello everyone. In this video, let's learn about pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. At the end of this session, students shall be able to enumerate various enzymes and coenzymes of pyruvate dehydrogenase complex and explain its functions and significance. In the previous videos on glycolysis, we have studied that pyruvate is the end product of aerobic glycolysis. Now, what are the different fates of pyruvate? This pyruvate can be reduced to lactate by the action of enzyme lactate dehydrogenase in anaerobic glycolysis. This pyruvate can be oxidatively decarboxylated to acetyl-CoA by the action of enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase. Pyruvate can undergo carboxylation to form oxaloacetate. And the enzyme which catalyzes this reaction is pyruvate carboxylase. The other fate is transamination. Pyruvate is transaminated to alanine by the action of enzyme alanine aminotransferase, and this process is called transamination. So these are the different fates of pyruvate. We are going to learn about this oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvate, in which pyruvate dehydrogenase complex plays a very important role in the conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA. Glycolysis occurs in cytosol, and this pyruvate is the end product of glycolysis, which has to be oxidized in the TCA cycle, which is located in the mitochondrial matrix. So to undergo TCA cycle, this pyruvate has to be converted into acetyl-CoA. This is the schematic representation of cell showing cytosol. This is mitochondria. This is outer mitochondrial membrane, and this is the inner mitochondrial membrane. This pyruvate, which is present in the cytosol, this can cross outer mitochondrial membrane. But to cross this inner mitochondrial membrane, it has to take help of pyruvate hydrogen symport. And this pyruvate hydrogen symport, it is located in inner mitochondrial membrane. And pyruvate dehydrogenase complex is also located in the inner mitochondrial membrane, which converts pyruvate into acetyl-CoA, and then this acetyl-CoA can undergo TCA cycle. Pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, it is a multi-enzyme complex because it contains three enzymes, E1, E2 and E3. Enzyme E1 is a pyruvate dehydrogenase. E2 is dihydrolipoyl transacetylase, and third enzyme is dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase. Each enzyme carries out certain functions, and these enzymes have coenzymes also. For example, the coenzyme thymine pyrophosphate, it is associated with pyruvate dehydrogenase. Lipoamide is associated with dihydrolipoyl transacetylase, and FAD is associated with dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase. What is the importance of this multi-enzyme complex? This multi-enzyme complex increases the efficiency of reaction because the intermediate which is formed by the first enzyme, it is not just released in the medium, it is channeled to the reaction that is catalyzed by the successive enzyme, and that this makes the whole reaction very efficient. This is the significance of multi-enzyme complex. What is the overall reaction that is carried out by this complex? It is the oxidative decarboxylation of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA. Here NADH is formed and acetyl-CoA is also formed. Carbon dioxide is also produced, and this acetyl-CoA is channeled to TCA cycle. Now let's study the reaction catalyzed by pyruvate dehydrogenase complex in detail. First, pyruvate binds with thymine pyrophosphate. This thymine pyrophosphate, it is a coenzyme. It is associated with pyruvate dehydrogenase. And there is formation of hydroxyethyl thymine pyrophosphate. The hydroxyethyl moiety is transferred from this pyruvate to the TPP to form hydroxyethyl thymine pyrophosphate, and there is release of carbon dioxide. So this is the decarboxylation reaction which is catalyzed by pyruvate dehydrogenase. So pyruvate dehydrogenase, it causes decarboxylation of pyruvate. So in this reaction, what is formed? Hydroxyethyl thymine pyrophosphate is form. It is the intermediate in this reaction. Now in the next reaction, this acetyl group is transferred to oxidized lipoamide, and after its transfer there is formation of acetyl lipoamide. Acetyl group from this hydroxyethyl thiamine pyrophosphate is transferred to oxidized lipoamide to form acetyl lipoamide, and TPP is regenerated back. And this is carried out by the enzyme dihydrolipoyl transacetylase. Next, what happens? The acetyl group, which is now attached to this acetyl lipoamide, it is transferred to coenzyme A to form acetyl coenzyme A. And this is how acetyl coenzyme A is formed in this reaction. And this acetyl lipoamide is then converted into reduced lipoamide. So what is the function of this dihydrolipoyl transacetylase? It transfers the acetyl group to the coenzyme A finally to form acetyl coenzyme A. Now this reduced lipoamide has to be converted into oxidized lipoamide. So here comes the third enzyme. So it occurs with the expense of FAD. This FAD is reduced to FADH2 by the action of enzyme dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase. And later on this hydrogen group is transferred to NAD to form NADH+H+. And then this NADH undergo oxidative phosphorylation to form 2.5 ATP in the electron transport chain. So what is the function of this dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase? It causes regeneration of oxidized form of lipoamide and transfers the electrons to NAD. So this is the function of dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase. So in this pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, there are three enzymes. First, pyruvate dehydrogenase, which causes decarboxylation of pyruvate. Second is dihydrolipoyl transacetylase, which causes transfer of acetyl group finally to coenzyme A to form acetyl coenzyme A. And third enzyme is dihydrolipoyl dehydrogenase, which causes regeneration of oxidized form of lipoamide and transfer of electrons to NAD to form NADH, which is later oxidized through electron transport chain to form ATP. You need not to remember all these structures. You have to just write the names of the component which are there in this particular reaction. There are five coenzymes which are involved in this reaction. The first coenzyme is thiamine pyrophosphate, which is derived from the vitamin B1, that is thiamine. Second is coenzyme A, which is derived from the vitamin pantothenic acid. Third is FAD. It is derived from riboflavin B2. NAD, it is derived from niacin, that is vitamin B3. And lipoamide, it is derived from lipoic acid. So there are five coenzymes in this reaction. And what is the energetics? From one molecule of pyruvate, there is formation of 2.5 ATP. So in the glycolysis, there is formation of two molecules of pyruvate. So when these two molecules of pyruvate converted into two molecules of acetyl CoA, there is formation of five molecules of ATP. Now let's talk about how this pyruvate dehydrogenase complex is regulated. It is regulated by two important mechanisms. First is the end product inhibition, and second is covalent modification. This is the overall reaction of which is catalyzed by pyruvate dehydrogenase complex, in which pyruvate it is converted to acetyl CoA. In this reaction, coenzyme A is involved, NAD is reduced to NADH+H+, which is later oxidized through electron transport chain, carbon dioxide is released in this reaction. So which are the end products here are acetyl-CoA and NADH. So this NADH, it will inhibit this enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase, and acetyl-CoA can also inhibit the enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase. So whenever there is increased production of NADH and acetyl-CoA, it can cause end product inhibition and it can slow down the rate of conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA. The second mechanism of regulation of pyruvate dehydrogenase is regulation by covalent modifications, that is phosphorylation and dephosphorylation. The conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA by pyruvate dehydrogenase and this pyruvate dehydrogenase is active in dephosphorylated condition and it is inactive in the phosphorylated form. So this dephosphorylated form is converted into phosphorylated form, that is the reaction of phosphorylation, it is carried out by enzyme pyruvate dehydrogenase kinase. And this kinase, it is stimulated by various molecules like acetyl-CoA, NADH and ATP. So whenever there is more formation of acetyl-CoA from pyruvate, whenever there is more production of NADH and ATP, in that case, the active form of PDH is converted into inactive form of PDH so that pyruvate should not be converted into acetyl-CoA. And when it is inhibited, when there is increased amount of coenzyme A, NAD+, and ADP as well as pyruvate. So this will inhibit this pyruvate dehydrogenase complex so that the phosphorylation should not occur and active form of pyruvate dehydrogenase should not be converted into inactive form so that pyruvate is converted into acetyl-CoA and further oxidized through TCA cycle. The dephosphorylation is carried out by the enzyme PDH phosphatase. And this PDH phosphatase, it is stimulated by insulin. And that's why in the well-fed condition, the PDH is in the active form, that is dephosphorylated form, and there is more formation of acetyl-CoA in the well-fed state. Along with this, magnesium and calcium are also stimulator of PDH phosphatase, which causes dephosphorylation and increase the formation of acetyl-CoA. Now let's talk about the clinical significance of pyruvate dehydrogenase complex. We know that the conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, it is the linking step between the glycolysis and Krebs cycle. So first pyruvate, it gets decarboxylated to acetyl-CoA, acetyl-CoA enters TCA cycle, reducing equivalents are generated and these reducing equivalents are then oxidized through electron transport chain to form ATP. So if there is no conversion of pyruvate to acetyl-CoA, in such condition there is no energy formation. So whenever there is defect in this PDH complex or if there is defect in the pyruvate dehydrogenase enzyme, in such condition there is no formation of acetyl-CoA and it leads to increased accumulation of pyruvate. Now this accumulated pyruvate get reduced into lactate. And here NADH is oxidized to NAD. And whenever there is increased production of lactate, it leads to the condition of lactic acidosis. So any defect in the PDH complex or pyruvate dehydrogenase deficiency, there is lactic acidosis. So why does this occur? Why there is formation of lactate from pyruvate whenever there is PDH complex defect is there? So this is for the adaptation. Because whenever there is increased accumulation of pyruvate, lactate production occurs to regenerate this NAD+. Because now, as the cell cannot get energy from the aerobic glycolysis, it has to survive and it is now entirely dependent on the anaerobic type of glycolysis, that is the energy which is derived from substrate level phosphorylation. And to continue this anaerobic type of glycolysis, cell is in the requirement of this NAD which is required in the step number 6. So now to get the abundance supply of this NAD, this pyruvate has to be converted into lactate to form NAD so that this NAD is utilized here in this step and further there is formation of energy by substrate level phosphorylation. That's why as an adaptation, the pyruvate is reduced to lactate whenever there is PDH complex defect and it leads to the condition called as lactic acidosis. So whenever there is inherited PDH deficiency, though it is rare, but it is the most common biochemical cause of congenital lactic acidosis. It results in the neurological disturbances because brain is entirely dependent on glucose and if glucose cannot be oxidized through the TCA cycle as there is no formation of acetyl-CoA, then it leads to neurological disturbances. The molecules like arsenite, mercuric ions, they interfere with the sulfhydryl group of lipoic acid which is associated with pyruvate dehydrogenase complex and interfere with the function of this PDH complex. TPP, that is thymine pyrophosphate. It is also coenzyme of pyruvate dehydrogenase. So whenever there is dietary deficiency of thymine, in that condition this PDH complex becomes defective. And this dietary deficiency is most common in alcoholics because alcohol inhibits the absorption of thymine in the intestine. So in such condition there is formation of lactate, which results in the lactic acidosis. Glucose can be converted into fats, but fat cannot be converted into glucose. Why? Because of the irreversibility of this reaction. Pyruvate is converted into acetyl-CoA, but the conversion of acetyl-CoA to pyruvate is not possible. This is completely irreversible reaction. Only exception is that the glycerol part of triacyl glycerol and propionyl-CoA, which is the end product of odd chain fatty acid oxidation, these two, they can undergo the gluconeogenesis to form glucose. So we can say that fat cannot be converted to glucose except the glycerol and propionyl-CoA.